Hi, today we're going to rig a flower sack. This is a common exercise when learning classical 2D animation. The sack is a basic rectangular shape, so it's perfect to learn to pose and make simple animations. If you can convey emotion with a simple sack, you will be able to do the same with a more complex character. Today, the skeleton we are making will use a hip, spine, shoulder setup that you can use as the basis for any biped rig. Let's begin. In setup mode, select the bone create tool, hold Ctrl and select the sack attachment, then drag to create a bone. Split the bone into two nested bones. Next, let's create bones for each corner of the sack. Select the sack bone and click to create a child bone, then drag to create one more bone. Let's do the same on the other side. Now, let's select the sack 2 bone and do the same to create bones for the upper corners. All our bones are named sack plus a number, which makes for a big mess. This would get confusing later, so it's worth it to spend a few seconds now to give the bones sensible names. Now, let's create a transform constraint. First, select the corner bottom backbone, choose New, Transfer Constraint, and click the corner bottom front bone. Give the transform constraint a name, like Corners Bottom. Click Match and set Translate X and Y to -100. Do the same for the top corner bones. The basic setup is done. Moving a front corner causes the back corner to move in the opposite direction, giving a 3D effect. Now, let's change the sack into a mesh and bind it to the bones. First, bind the sack and sack 2 bones and make sure it bends well. Next, add the corner bones. Spine's automatic weight does a good job for most of the bones, but we will manually adjust the ear bones. Switch to animate mode and rotate each ear bone individually, then reduce the weights that we don't want. It is usually easier to remove weights than to try adding it. I could spend more time on these weights, but this is looking good enough for now. The last thing I want to add is a bone to control the middle of the sack. Back in setup mode, select the sack bone and create a new bone. Give it a name and bind it to the mesh. In animate mode, make a looping animation that moves the bones between their extreme positions. This helps a lot when adjusting weights. To get a smooth transition between the weights, I will use Mesh Soft Selection with Feather set to 100. This basic skeleton can be a starting point for many of your characters. Even with this simple sack of flour, you can have a lot of fun animating. Share with us some of your flower sack animations. Have fun and happy animating!